Hello you all, and welcome back to my little corner on the internet. If you made a little one, and this little one is in a PDF in my Etsy shop, it's very easy, you can purchase it over there. Then you want to dress it, of course. Now, the previous tutorial was about making these cute little hats and about making these cute little wigs. Have to cut that off or have to turn it inside out. Okay. Now we're going to make this little dungaree. And I have prepared already a couple. They are very easy to make. And the recipe is still the same every time you do it. It's in one, not quite in one piece. You have to attach it here and there, but I will show you. And then it closes up with a little button on the back side. So that makes this little dungaree removable. And that was what I was aiming for, because I like to dress it up sometimes in another color or anything I want. So it's easily removable. So here he is naked. Now, I like to use cotton. You can do this with a sock yarn, a fingering weight yarn as well, of course. But I like to use the cotton because where I came from or where I live, they are available in these tiny little balls, and that's more than enough for a dungaree and a hat. And there are a great variety of colors, so that's why I do the cotton. And I like the feel of it. It is sturdy. So it's easy to put it on and to take it off. Okay, so I prepared a little bit. Now, you're going to chain 26 stitches. 26 stitches you're going to chain. Okay, and then you're going to close it into a circle with a slip stitch in the first stitch, of course. Okay, I had a hairpin, but it's gone now. Oh, here it is. There's my hairpin again. I always use it because I'm working in a spiral, but I need to know where I started the row. Okay, now I did a slip stitch in that first stitch, but that's not enough. I'm going back in it and I'm going to make a single crochet, as we call it, with one thread. Now I have two. Okay. And I'm going to do that all around. Put your pin there where you started your round. And I'm going to do this in the round. Just a couple of stitches to show you. It's always a bit fiddly the first round, but it will become easier. All the way in the round, and when I'm at that pin, I know that I've done one round, so I can show you now that you're going to do 8 rounds. This is the first one, and you're going to make 8 rows 8 times in the round, just single crochets, just making this tube. Okay, I guess that's clear. So you get a little tube over here, and then we're going to move on with the legs. So now you have 8 rows of single crochet, so you have something like this, a little tube. So now we're going to make the first leg. That is the 9th round, if you would like to call it that way. So I already made, here was where the 8th round ended. So I already made single crochets over 13 stitches. Remember, we cast it on 26 stitches. So half of them is 13 stitches. And instead of going on in the same round, you're going to fold over your tube like this, and we're going to make short rounds now. So make sure that your thread is behind your work from this side to the back, okay? Then we're going to stitch into that first stitch, and I always try to keep close to my hairpin, and we're going to close that with that single crochet. And from now on, we're going to do 4 rounds of single crochets, including the round which I'm doing right now. 4 rounds. And it's a good idea, once you've crocheted all the way back to this point, to count whether you have still your 13 stitches. When you have 12, you can be satisfied, because that's that will fit also. But when you think, I want to stick to that 13, or when you have less, no matter how that happens, then you can always make a stitch in between over here, an extra stitch. Okay? It shouldn't be necessary, of course, but you never know. Officially, here is where the first stitch starts, and that's really a difficult stitch to pick to your hook. So what I like to do is, I'd like to take a needle somewhat thicker than this one, even thicker than this one. This will do, okay? And I just go in, that's easier than my hook, and make it a little bit wider, stretch it a bit, so then I can easily go into that stitch. It's just a little trick. So you do 4 rounds and then you bind off. The binding off, like I do it, is just, and I will do it here in this spot, but of course I'm not keeping that definitive. I'm not going to cut my thread. The way I do it is just insert my hook in the upfollowing stitch and make a slip stitch before I'm going to cut my thread. Okay, I'm not going to do that in this case because I'm not finished with those 4 rounds. Okay, it's in again. I'm not finished with those 4 rounds, but that's the way I finish off when I need to bind off. After those 4 rounds, I'm coming back to show you how you to attach your thread to the first stitch, because you have to do another leg. Okay, one leg is done. And as you can see, I like to weave in my ends as I go, so I don't have so many threads hanging out. Okay, the second leg, take your thread, go into the first stitch that isn't used, and just pull your thread through it, make a slip stitch, and go in that same stitch again and make a single crochet. Oops, that's my first. I still use my hairpin because I'm still working in a spiral, and that keeps me informed of where I am. So the next leg is exactly the same. You just go in the round 4 times. After the first round, you just check if you have enough stitches. On this leg I checked and it happened to be 12. And that's more than enough, so no problem. 13, 12, both is more than enough. So I'm going to finish this leg. Okay, so now we have a little pants with 2 legs on it, and we only need to make this little part and the 2 strings, bands, that go over his shoulders. I hope I can make it. I haven't got this much left, but I think it will do. Now what I did is, I placed my hairpin in the middle. It's not rocket science, just point a line out from here to upwards and take that stitch which is the most in the middle. Because these were the chain stitches with which we started. And when we crocheted it on one side, we used one leg, as I call them, from that chain stitch that leaves us another leg to work in. So I put my hairpin in the middle, in one of them, and I'm going to count. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to start 1, 2, 3, 4, and this one is 5. I have to stay in camera, and that's a bit fiddly. Okay, I'm in. So this is going to be the first 2, 3, 4, 5. And of course, I will be going on 4 stitches after the middle one. Okay, let me attach the yarn again, exactly the same. Go through, make a slip stitch, and in the same spot make a single crochet. And now that's just something I do because I don't like to weave in so much ends. I'm going to leave this tail, that's the tail, flat to the surface so I can crochet around it. Next stitch is here. Again, for me it's a bit difficult because I'm on a distance of my work. See, the tail is lying over my hook as well, and I'm going to make the chain stitch over it. Okay, and just move on. That's 3. I'm going to take my pin out, so I have to take in account that I already did 3, and that this is 4. I have to work more towards me. I will try it to do it this way. I have to work more towards me, but I'm going to make, including that middle stitch, there are 9 single crochets. I have 9. We are going to turn the work, and we're going to crochet backwards. I'm not going to crochet in the first one. This would be the first one. This one here. I'm going to start in the second one. That's 1. Oops, sorry. That's 1. Hope I'm still in camera. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I want to do 7. So that means that I decreased 2. So here are the 2 last stitches that are left. I'm going in the first one, just make a loop, go in the second one. Oops, might have to use my tool to give it some other room. Oops, come on. Yes, there we go. Bring a loop upward, so we have 3 loops on your needle, and then take 1 loop and go through all 3 that were on your needle. That's a decrease too. So where you start, you're just going to skip the first, and where you end, you're going to make a decrease by making 1 crochet using 2 underneath lying crochets. Going to turn my work, and I'm going to do that once more. So I skip the first, and I'm going to crochet until I have 2 left, and then I'm going to do 1 loop, a second loop, and go through both of them. So these are, the first are 9, the second 7, and the last are 5 single crochets. Now we're not going to bind off, we're going to make that first string, and for that you're going to chain 15 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I'm going to stitch into the sixth from my hook. So that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 into this one. So I'm getting a little bit of a loop at the end. And I'm going to make slip stitches. Now, not single crochets, but slip stitches in the rest of those chains. Until I reach the end. So when I am at the end, it looks like this. And I'm going to secure it by making one slip stitch into the last single crochet that we made on top of this, and make a slip stitch so that it lays nice against that upper part. Then I'm going to turn my work, so I'm not binding off. I'm going to turn my work and make slip stitches all the way over the top of that part until I reach the other end. I'm here. The last one, always a bit difficult. And now I'm going to do exactly the same as I did over here. I'm going to chain 15, make a little loop by sticking into the sixth chain stitch from my hook, and slip stitch all the way back. So there you have it, a little dungaree. I made that second string. I've woven in all my ends. I attached a little button on the back side, put those strings around it, and there it is. Now, you need to use a small button, but I would recommend to try your button through the loop before you're going to stitch it on to be sure that it goes through. And when you have these kinds of buttons, it gives you a little bit more room to put your strings around. It's not called strings, straps, to go to put your straps over the top, but it is sticking out more than this little button, and it works also. So, hope you enjoyed this little video. Now, if you want to make it from felt, well, I don't think I have to make a tutorial about that. Just lay your little dungaree in front of you and make a little pattern of the front side and make a little pattern of the back side. And then I would recommend to cut the straps. It has to come off. Okay. To cut the straps when you lay it in front of you, already, just draw it already on your felt, or first on paper and then on your felt. So including these two straps. And when you have a good quality of felt, you can make a little cut in it to make a little hole, a little button hole. And just the back side is, of course, just this piece. So the only two seams you have to close are these seams and a little V in the middle. I won't be doing a tutorial about that because it's so simple that I think you can figure it out how to do that. Hope you enjoyed it, and see you next time.